Morning, nice to speak to you, and thank you very much for the invite, Emma. Thank you. I'm quite wee, so this microphone is sort of blocking you out here. So, you know, everyone always starts by saying it's quite a hard act to follow, and I was a little bit annoyed to have to follow someone who's talking about tiger research. So I feel like that's going to be a struggle. So I'm a neurology consultant. I work in Edinburgh. I do a bit of general neurology. I do some work, including some MS research and involved with some of the projects that Javier mentioned, and also work as clinical lead for Huntington's locally. And I've been doing that for a small number of years, trying to remember exactly. So I'm just going to try and do probably quite a short overview, and I'm going to keep this reasonably non-technical, and that's mainly because I am reasonably non-technical, but I'll not divulge that. So I'm just going to talk really about the sort of how I've gone about trying to build on what was already there for research in Huntington's from the perspective of working in Edinburgh. So generally, you know, you've got the situation where you've got really sort of fertile ground. You've got people who are keen to participate in research, and I recognise several of the faces that Louise showed in the SHA slide there. You know, there's people that are keen to get involved, have something to offer. There's actual sort of physical infrastructure, so there's an enrolling clinic that I work out of with dedicated research staff there. There's the NDN and particular help from Jackie, who I can't, she's up there, hello, yep, who I won't embarrass. And generally there's a situation, there's people, and there's a lot of potential there. So potential hurdles though, so let's say, so when I'm seeing somebody in the clinic, I'm usually seeing them with the SHE specialist, and it's a reasonably small clinical team. There's quite a lot of clinical demands on team members, so people have talked about this earlier. So there's a lot of things pulling people in different directions, and research definitely is a priority, but it's one of many priorities. You know, my time, admin time, there are some potential hurdles to jump over. And I put up this slide of people sort of hurdling enthusiastically over as part of the steeplechase, just for contrast with the next one. And what I want, yeah, this is generally what I wanted to sort of avoid. So we want to keep that forward momentum, keep going, get through the obstacles, but at the same time not get overwhelmed. So from my point of view, trying to build research around Huntington's locally, particularly sort of doable for participants and is important, you know, useful for participants. Is this something that they are going to get something out of? Maybe not directly, you know, maybe they get the experience of being part of research, but is this something that's going to lead to wider gains and is going to help move the field forward? Is it doable for us in time, in terms of sort of time, resources, funding, personnel? And I suppose also building local experience. So I didn't want to necessarily jump in at the really deep end. Things that we have set up locally, I'll just talk about these sort of briefly. At the top is a nice logo for Enroll HD that Louise already mentioned. So this was already in place when I started, and we've kept this going. And I work on that along with Philip, who's a genetic counsellor. And this is a, you know, as mentioned, a ginormous observational cohort study, and also, you know, so you see people roughly annually, you do a lot of tests, and that goes into an anonymized database, and that in itself is used for research, but can also be used as a step off for interventional studies. Health ERND is a large European study which came out kind of pre-COVID, and the idea is to look at determinants and measurement of quality of life in people with Huntington's and their caregivers. And it's at the moment, it's at a stage of developing a validated questionnaire to do that. And we hope to involve people locally in the Lothian area in assessing that questionnaire. The idea previously was that this is then used to assess RCT, a randomized controlled trial, looking at how effective telehealth interventions are for provision of Huntington's care. And I think that's in the process of being kind of reconsidered a little bit, given that we've now moved to that model quite a lot, given COVID. So, you know, the ground has shifted since that was set up. The Edinburgh Brain and Tissue Bank, so essentially we had a little bit of funding came through Joseph Priller, and we can now sign people up to that, and we've got a small number of people who are signed up for brain donation. IMARC HD is just something we signed up as a PIC site recently, so a sort of peripheral site where we send people to this study. This is a London longitudinal imaging study where they do lots of tests, including scans, and they repeat it over time. We haven't started sending people towards that yet, but so it's probably quite demanding for people, I think, but quite a good opportunity to be involved in. And sort of similar to Enroll, the idea is it can also be used as a step off for interventional studies. The Join HD at the bottom, I only came across this very recently. So this refers to juvenile onset Huntington's disease. So there's a large, you know, most people with Huntington's are diagnosed in the middle age. There'll be a few people who are diagnosed when they're quite a lot younger. And we've got a couple of people, one of whom turned up on the slides earlier. So I sent out information on this. This came through one of the big European research collaboratives, and I got an email saying, have you got anybody that's interested in this? So I sent out information to the couple of people we have locally, and then I had one of them in clinic just very recently, and it turns out actually the mum's involved in co-production of this, and she's actually involved in setting up the participant information and was giving me feedback that she doesn't like QR codes, but she quite likes the colouring of the leaflets and things. So it was quite an interesting experience where I started to tell her about it, and she very much turned the tables and said, well, actually, you know, I've been involved in that for the last year or so. And but, you know, she's incredibly positive and engaged and interested. So, yeah, hopefully these are all studies that, you know, so all part of a bigger collaborative effort. They're not ones where we have set them up from scratch. They're not ones where we've gone and sought separate funding. I'd hope to just kind of keep building in that over time. So that's us. Yeah, thanks. And I don't know what we do. So I think we're maybe not quite tiger research, but I think we're going to move on to much more kind of zingy things with Gillian's. Gillian's photos are going to be pretty exciting. So I'm going to hand you over to Gillian, okay? Thanks very much.